The objective is to compare fractions greater than 1 by creating common numerators or denominators. Let's look to compare 3 and 7 twelfths and 3 and 3 fourths. How might we compare them? Well, we have 3's here, so that we can just compare the two fractions, 7 twelfths and 3 fourths. You may notice that 3 fourths is related, and the fourths is related to the twelfths. How would we get from fourths to twelfths? Right, we can rename 3 fourths as 9 twelfths. And then, since we now have a common denominator, we can just compare them. And that we know that 7 is less than 9, so that 3 and 7 twelfths is less than 3 and 3 fourths. Let's use the same type of strategy for 4 and 1 third and 4 and 2 ninths. Which of those will we rename? We know that they're related. We have ninths and we also have thirds. We have fours as our whole, so we can compare the fractions again. And then so we're looking at 1/3 and we're also looking at 2/9. 1/3 we can rewrite as how many ninths? Right, we can triple so that we have 3/9. And 3/9 is greater than 2/9, so that 4 1/3 is bigger than 4 2/9. If we look at a number line, both of those mixed numbers are in between 4 and 5. If we go by thirds, there's 4 1/3. And then we see that 4 1/3 is actually equal to 4 3/9. So if that's 4 3/9, then what we do here is each of these parts is then tripled to be able to get to ninths. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So that 4 2/9 would be placed right here on the number line. And that 4 1/3 then is bigger and larger than 4 2/9 based upon our number line. Okay, it's your turn. Note that this is the first problem after you finish watching the video, so you'll be able to put in your answer there. Take a moment to compare 5 1/4 and 5 3/8. Look to get a common denominator. Please pause the video while you do your work. Which of those did you change? Did you change 5 1/4? To 5 2/8, then it's easy to compare 5 2/8 and 5 3/8. The 5 wholes are the same, and 2/8 is less than 3/8. We'd also be able to draw a tape diagram just for those fractional parts, and then we could stack them. Here's fourths, so that there is 1/4. And then here's another tape diagram there, where it is that we would have to have twice the amount of parts there, and then we would have 3 in there. And then so if we equate and make them equal for denominators, in other words, have the same number of parts, 8s, we know that 1/4 is equal to 2/8. And that 3/8 is bigger than 2/8. So we have different ways of looking at this to be able to help us compare the fractions and mixed numbers. When we're asked to compare these, you'll notice 4 3/4, 23/5, we have an improper fraction here and a mixed number. It would help if we had the same thing, meaning have them both as mixed numbers. When we see 23 over 5, we should be thinking 23 divided by 5. 5 goes into 23 four whole times, with 3 remaining. So 23 fifths equals 4 and 3 fifths. That means we can just compare 3 fourths with 3 fifths. We'll notice that the numerators are the same, the denominators are different. And is it fourths that are bigger or fifths that are bigger? Think. Is it fourths that are bigger or fifths that are bigger? Well, we think about that. We have fourths there, and then we have fifths there. Right, fourths are bigger. So that 3/4 is going to be bigger or larger than 3/5. So 4 3/4 is bigger than 23/5. Read that expression with me. 4 3/4 is greater than 23/5. Okay, it's your turn to do some work again. We have 3 7/10, and we have 18/5. Go ahead and pause the video while you do your work. Did you rewrite the improper fraction 18/5 as a mixed number? What mixed number did you get? Ideally, you got 3 3/5. Did you then look for a common denominator? The common denominator would be 10, so you'd multiply the numerator and denominator by 2. So you would have 3 6/10 compared with 3 7/10. 3 7/10 is larger, so that 3 7/10 is greater than 18/5. Check over your work. Let's look at one last problem. Here we have 4 2/3, and we're comparing it with 4 7/12. Which of those would we change? Well, we're going to go ahead and break apart the larger unit, which are the thirds there, to twelfths. So we'll take 2/3 again, which is the larger unit, to break it apart to twelfths. And then so that way we'll be able to compare those two. Here's thirds. And to get to twelfths, we'd have to divide each of those into 4 parts to be able to get 12 parts total. So that's 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So we have 7/12 there. And then let's see, 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 to make 4 times as many parts. And that's 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So 4 2/3 is equal to, times 4 is equal to 4 8/12, and 4 8/12 is bigger than 4 7/12. And there's our work. Again, what we did is we found a common denominator so that we were able to compare those fractions.